In this video, we're comparing the Rotofab cold air intake to the Camaro ZL1 1LE's stock airbox with an aftermarket green filter. Is the Rotofab going to live up to its hype, or is it full of hot air? Stick around, the results might surprise you. So Rotofab intakes are a favorite modification for the Camaro SS and the Camaro ZL1. The Rotofab has shown to increase power during dyno tests, but most of the time the hood is open during those tests. The Rotofab is blocked off by some baffle plates. It's not a completely sealed air intake, so it is ingesting some amount of hot air when the hood is closed. The Camaro SS intake actually has a more of a sealed 360-degree airbox that hooks up to the factory snorkel, but it is still open at the top. The factory airbox, however, is completely sealed. It's a plastic airbox. It's got a gasket that seals to the snorkel that is behind the driver's side headlight, and so it is only getting outside air into the air filter. The Rotofab filter, the surface area of the conical filter, is approximately twice that of the panel filter. But there is an important fact. The depth of the pleats on the panel filter are almost twice as deep. So if you cut this filter open and laid the filter media out, the panel filter would be pretty close to the overall filter surface area. During track days with my Camaro ZL1, where the ambient temperature was above 80 degrees, I was getting slowdowns. I was losing horsepower on the straights, and I was losing 6 mph of top speed. That, in combination with some video from Banks Power, made me start to wonder if there weren't other solutions out there that might reduce the inlet air temperature and increase power, or at least reduce power drop.
So this is our starting point. Ambient air density is our starting point. So we're on 100% J607 day. We're at 76.4 pounds of air per 1,000 feet. Now we're gonna run the engine. With that air density and those conditions, that engine will make 661 horsepower at 7,000 RPM. It's a nice little 427 naturally aspirated. Wait a minute, this guy put his air filter under the hood. What is he thinking? You read the magazines all the time and you see pictures like this. Ah, he's got the filter under the hood. Must be low restriction, huh? That filter on a stick has a MAP loss of about 0.7 pounds, that's filter drop. But the air going into it is 135 degrees instead of 60. So instead of 661 horsepower, we're now making 550. Pure jackassery. It's not about the pressure, it's about the temperature, and more importantly, it dropped the density. Your density went from 100% to 83%, the MAD, the top reading. That's kind of criminal.
We're using the Chevrolet Performance Data Recorder, or PDR, which is a factory option with the Camaros, to capture lap data, which includes some of the OBD2 data. We're going to be capturing outside air temp, ambient air temp, calculated horsepower, boost, and RPM. Then we're going to use Cosworth Pi Toolbox, which is a free software package that allows us to get into that data. And we'll get all of that data for each of the straightaways at Carolina Motorsports Park with a very, very close ambient air temp. So the graph shows ECU calculated horsepower and inlet air temperature measured after the air filter. The results dispute the conventional wisdom that the Rotofab intake is better. On average, IAT, our inlet air temperature, was 13 degrees hotter and made 10 less horsepower than the factory airbox with a green filter. There was some expected data scatter, but the factory airbox was better at each point. Now keep in mind, this was a heat-soaked car several laps into a road course session. So there was a lot of heat in the engine bay. So any air that was making its way in from the engine compartment into the air filter was degrading performance. Now the factory seal box does not suffer that, and had much more consistent IAT temperatures across the board. I'm sure some of you will have different experiences, and this contradicts the conventional wisdom that the Rotofab intake is the way to go. Please post any of those different experiences in the comments below. Based on the data, I'm going to continue to run the green filter with the factory airbox due to the lower IATs and the higher calculated horsepower. In a future video, we're also going to strap the car down to a dyno. Please like and subscribe if you like this content, and we'll see you on the next video. Thanks for watching.